My name is Paul England. I'm a distinguished engineer at Microsoft, and I'm working on Project Origin. I've been at Microsoft for over 20 years, and mostly I work on platform security technologies. Over the last year, I've been working with Rico Malvar and other media experts within Microsoft and outside on Project Origin. So Origin is a system which Microsoft is building with partners to combat the huge problem that society has with misinformation on the web right now. So what we're trying to do with the Origin project is to sort of elevate traditional news media so that people can see where news is coming from, and in particular, more credence from news that's coming from the sources that they trust. What we observe is that fake media is getting better and better and better, and the ability for computers to tell what's real and what's fake, or users to tell what's real and what's fake, is rapidly tending to zero. So rather than trying to detect fake media on the internet, what we're trying to do with Project Origin is to try and put a provenance or authentication layer on media on the web, so that when you get a piece of media, simplistically, you can see where it came from. We can work with any sort of media, simple media, just like a text file or a PDF document, say, but also audio, also imagery. But the sort of media that we've been focusing most on in Project Origin is video. So what do we mean by an authentication or provenance layer for media? So there are three things we're trying to do with the Origin system. The first is we're trying to authenticate the source of the video. We want to be able to reliably authenticate it as coming from that source. The next thing we want to ensure is that the video has not been modified since it was published by the publisher. So we want to detect, or worry about at least, modifications like video being clipped to be taken out of context. And we want to make sure that no other modifications have been made to the video that kind of destroy the intent of the news organization or publisher when they published it. The third thing we want to do with the Origin system is to allow the publisher to associate metadata with the video. So metadata is any sort of tag that the publisher thinks is important to improve the context or the background of the video. So that could be just something as simple as the title of the video. It could be the people that are in the video. It could be the date the video was recorded. If a video is an edited copy of several things that are assembled together, the metadata could include the source information for that video. So how do we add this provenance layer to video in Project Origin? The starting point is something we call a manifest. You can think of a manifest as a digital envelope that contains the video or other media and the metadata we talked about. So the manifest is cryptographically bound to the video that it's describing. And the purpose of the cryptographic binding is to make sure that any modification to the video will break the association between the manifest and the video that it's describing. So this is the way we guard against adversarial modification of the video, which people are doing to try and mislead the viewer that the video is something other than it says it is. So now we have a manifest. The manifest is bound to the video through this cryptographic binding. It contains the metadata, but we're still not quite there. The final thing we need to do is to make sure that nobody else can make a manifest for the video that says it's something other than it is. And the way we do this is with something called a digital signature. A digital signature is very much like a handwritten signature, but sort of better. Handwritten signatures are meant to prove who wrote a particular document. A digital signature does exactly the same thing, but it's based on a cryptographic key. And as long as the publisher keeps that cryptographic key secret so no one else can get at it, then we know no way that somebody else could forge a digital signature for a manifest. So the manifest, bound to the media, and now signed using a digital signature, is our main building block for building trust in media with Project Origin. However, we go beyond that simple system in a variety of ways. The first thing is we add an extra layer of security beyond the digital signature by allowing the manifests, essentially these videos, to be placed on a public ledger or blockchain. Many of you have probably heard about blockchains. It's the same technology that underlies modern electronic currencies like Bitcoin. But blockchains and public ledgers are actually very interesting security technologies that have a wide range of uses. And the way we're using them in Project Origin is to allow people to place their videos and their manifests on these blockchains. And so everybody in a very public way can see what was published, when it was published, the order that things were published. In Project Origin, we've been experimenting with a Microsoft blockchain technology called CCF for Confidential Computing Framework. We believe that because there are many different blockchain technologies with different security characteristics, that eventually we will be able to support multiple blockchains so that any particular use case or scenario can pick the blockchain technology that's most appropriate for the security guarantee that you're trying to give. So the second trick we're adding with Project Origin is something we call a manifest database. So ideally, when you watch a video on the web, the manifest for that video will be there. So the app you're using to watch the video, or the website you're using to watch the video, or the browser can consume that manifest and display that information to the user. However, because video delivery is extremely complicated, with video taking many different paths to users through different content distribution networks, through different social media platforms, we think that it's likely that early on, manifests are sort of going to get lost from the point of publication to the point they're consumed. So our manifest database allows you as a consumer of a video or tools on your machine, your app say that's playing the video, to query our database and see whether there's a manifest for the video that you're watching. The challenge is that in order to check a digital signature, you normally have to download the whole document to check that no bit has been modified from what's specified in the manifest and what you're playing. But the way modern video distribution works is it's progressively transmitted. You don't need to wait for 2 gigabytes of video to download. You just have to download a couple of seconds of video and then your player starts playing it. And so we need our authentication system to work in the same way. Rather than authenticating the whole video, we have to be able to authenticate a few seconds at a time. So we need to make sure that our provenance and authentication system works with modern video delivery today. The final thing we have to deal with Project Origin is video delivery is very, very complicated. You might think that as a publisher, you put a video up on the website and then everybody watches that video, but that's not the way it works any longer. If you put a video on a website, typically what will happen is the website or the content distribution network or the social media platform, or even a company like Netflix, they take that video and they re-encode the video into many different formats that are optimized for different purposes. We need to build a manifest that can describe dozens or even hundreds of videos for these different representations that are used to provide this adaptive bitrate transmission we see for videos today. So how do we do this? We built something which we call a transformation manifest. And what a transformation manifest is, it allows a publisher or a social media platform to say, this video that you're watching now is a faithful reproduction of some other source video. And these transformation manifests can be built for the dozens or hundreds of copies of a video that that are needed to support this adaptive bitrate transmission. And as far as the user's concerned, they just think that they're seeing a video from the new source that they expected. We think that social media platforms that will adopt this technology and will be building these transformation manifests to make sure that the information the publisher put into the video is properly conveyed to users. However, we still think that in the next few years, as we build this ecosystem, videos are going to be seen that have not gone through this sort of care during transmission. And essentially, they're going to lose their manifests and lose their bindings. So we're also researching a set of technologies that we call fingerprinting technologies, which allow tools to establish that one video is a faithful reproduction of another video. For more technical information about Project Origin, please follow these links. The Exploring Project Origin site contains a deep dive on many of the issues we've discussed, and the archive paper contains even more information. The GitHub link contains information about CCF, and the Project Origin blog will be updated with our latest news. So Microsoft is working with our partners to bring together a set of technology and news and other companies to work together on building this provenance layer in Project Origin. So the standards organization that Microsoft is putting together with its partners to address the problem of provenance in media is called CCPA, or the Coalition for Content Provenance and Authenticity. And I encourage you to find out more about this organization and maybe even participate in our work. Thank you.